All right, bleeders, it's time to answer the age-old question. Do we really need our periods every month? Hey everyone, Julia here for DNews. Periods, they're messy, uncomfortable, inconvenient, and expensive, seriously expensive. Some estimates say a woman will spend over 18,000 bucks over the course of her life on products like pads and tampons. I've about had it. I'm ready to never have a period again. But is that possible? Would it do any harm? I mean, every month your body prepares for one of life's greatest miracles. The lining of your uterus thickens in response to hormones like estrogen and progesterone. It grows in layers and becomes filled with blood vessels in preparation of egg implantation. If the egg becomes fertilized and implants itself in that lining, we call it pregnancy. But if that doesn't happen, your body punishes you by shedding the lining, giving you lots of cramps and just general messiness. But along came a little pink pill and changed everything. I mean, birth control has revolutionized so much in our society. From the little pink pill to the little copper coil, birth control gave women and those with a uterus control over their own bodies. So you know what? I say screw it. Who needs a period anyways? Turns out, no one. Not really. You don't really need your period. So are you ready to stop your period? How? Just a little pink pill every morning. Most birth control contains synthetic versions of the hormones progesterone and estrogen. These hormones prevent pregnancy in a few ways. Some types prevent ovulation by basically tricking your body into thinking it's already released an egg. This way, it doesn't release another one. And the progestin, the synthetic version of progesterone, actually prevents the buildup of the lining of your uterus and might also make the vaginal mucus thicker, making it more difficult for sperm to get where it's trying to go. Well, some pills you take every day for like 21 days and then take a placebo for a week to menstruate, other types stop menstruation completely, and this is completely fine, according to a 2006 study published in the journal Contraception. The following year, a pill that stops menstruation completely was approved by the FDA. The only downside, some people might experience some breakthrough bleeding or spotting throughout the month, and many, many women were really interested. One survey by the University of Pennsylvania School of Medicine found that more than two-thirds of women were interested in stopping their periods, and even more promising, 97% of physicians said suppressing menstruation is medically safe and acceptable. But I should caution that yes, there are some risks with oral contraceptives. An increased risk of blood clots, heart attacks, and stroke. But on the other hand, it might lower the risk of ovarian and endometrial cancers. And I know, this whole thing sounds so strange. You might think that we need periods to remove toxins or something, but that's an old belief, one of many, that tries to paint periods as disgusting and dirty. Like this one physician in 1920 claimed he found that women release menotoxins during their period that would actually wilt flowers if women touched them. Not even kidding. And there's nothing true about that, to say the least, but a lot of people still believe something close to that. So is having a period every month natural? Well, weirdly, some people think we actually are having more periods than we're supposed to. In societies that don't use birth control, they tend to have more children, a lot more. So women spend much more of their reproductive years pregnant or breastfeeding, meaning they menstruate less. Anthropologist Beverly Strassman of the University of Michigan says women in these societies typically have 100 periods over the course of their life, while women in societies like ours that use birth control have like 3 to 5 times as many periods. That's just not fair. And yeah, okay, having a period every month is a kind of nice reminder from Mother Nature that, hey, you are not pregnant! But there's other ways to know you're not pregnant. And hormonal birth control is reversible. According to the European Active Surveillance Study on Oral Contraceptives, most women had no problems getting pregnant after they stopped taking the pill. So basically, period havers of the world, rejoice! If the lining of your uterus doesn't thicken thanks to oral contraception, you really don't need a period. Alright ladies, so have you ever experienced those moments where you and your roommates are all on your periods at the same time? Ice cream and Grey's Anatomy party! But no, seriously, is that even possible? Amy has the answer in this episode, right here.
Since the 1970s, there have been a few studies to suggest that synchronized menstruation is possible between roommates, lesbian couples, and sexually segregated groups of women. But there have also been studies to suggest that synchrony isn't a real thing.
Alright ladies, so if you could never have a period again, would you do it? Let us know down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back to DNews so you don't miss a single episode.